to God with a voice of triumph. Sing unto him the song of the redeemed. Lift up a banner, banner of worship. He is our Savior, our King. Shout unto God with a voice. Sing unto him. Oh, banner of worship. He is our Savior, our King. For great is the Lord, for he is greatly to be praised. The whole earth is filled with his glory. The whole earth is filled with his glory. Oh,
shout unto God with the voice of triumph.
Sing unto him.
Oh,
lift up a banner. Banner of worship. House, I gotta lift my voice. Every time I come into God's house, I gotta give up my soul. Every time I come into God's house, I gotta give up my life. Why? Because I'm a living sacrifice.
Thank you.
Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Y'all listen, it's Friday, November the 5th, the fifth day of this month. It's a new month. I'm excited that it's Friday. We made it this far by faith. So let's take a moment and give God praise that we have got through this work week, that we've got through the beginning of this month. Y'all, God is worthy to be praised. Let's lift him up high right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. The tomb is still empty. Our Lord still reigns. He rests, rules, and abides right on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. Friday, November the 5th. Welcome to our True Vision Church, 12 o'clock noon prayer time. Y'all do me a favor right now. You've already been deputized. You're part of our True Vision Church live stream evangelistic team, as I call it. Amen. So do me a favor. Like this video. Share this video. Share it. If you're used to sharing, triple it. Share it five times. If you're not used to sharing, at least share it two times. This is the first time that you have shared one of our videos. Share it at least two times. Evangelize. Y'all have the easiest role in this evangelistic team. All you got to do is share it. Comment during this prayer time. Let's pray together. You're joining me in prayer. I'm not praying by myself. You're joining me in prayer. Subscribe to our YouTube so you can get notified of our latest videos that we post, and you know what, like or follow our Facebook page. That's so you can be notified of the latest content that's posted even there. But do this, y'all, do this as much as you can, because we want you and we want to grow this particular ministry, our prayer ministry. We want to grow it. How you doing? It's been a long week, I know. It's been a tough week, I know. But how are you doing? Give me your I am statement. Type that in right now. I'm blessed. I'm glad to be here. I'm so glad I made it. What is your I am statement today? But then I don't want you to stay down in the dumps. I don't want you to stay on that I am statement. I want you to boast on our Lord. I want you to name one thing that God did for you today. Not yesterday. Thursday is gone. Not Saturday. What did God do for you today on Friday? Amen. But we're gathered here for devotion and prayer. So I want you to hear from God's word through the book of Titus, chapter 3, verse 5, in our devotional prayer guide that's guiding us. It's called God's Purpose for Your Life. You're very familiar with it. Today's title for the devotion, today's title, I had it marked, a regenerated mind. Good Lord, a regenerated mind. So today's Titus chapter 3, verse 5, a regenerated mind. Then we're going to do our Lord's Prayer. We're going to do the Lord's Prayer, and then I'm going to pray for the unemployed and the underemployed. Thank you for joining me today. Make sure you share. Let's read scripture together. Titus chapter 3, verse 5. Verse 5. Not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy he saved us through the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit. Somebody type amen for the reading of God's holy word. Go ahead, type amen for the reading of God's holy word. Amen. The regeneration of our mind. Let's do our Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen, amen, and amen. Come on, church, join me in prayer for our unemployed and underemployed. Heavenly Father, most gracious Master, Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the author and finisher of our faith. Lord God, we thank you. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for starting us on our way. Food on our table, clothes on our back. Lord, if it had not been for you on our side, where would we be? So, Father, we're here on bended knee, asking for your hand of help, your hand of provision, your hand of wisdom, your hand of guidance. Father, I'm asking for this on behalf of those that are unemployed right now, those that are in a bit of a rut where they don't have income coming in. But Lord, I'm also lifting up those that they are employed, but it just never seems to be enough. But somehow you've always worked it out for them. But Father, we don't want any more hungry days. We don't want any more sleepless nights. We don't want any more dark nights where the lights have to go off, or dry nights where the water can't come on. Father, we need your hand. So Father, I ask that you give increase to those that are underemployed. I ask, Father, that you give promotion and employment to those that are unemployed. Let them find work on today. Let this Friday be a good Friday for even them. That, Lord, they realize that you never left them nor forsaken them, but you always worked it out for them. You kept them for this long, not so they can fail in this spot, not so they can die in this spot. This is not the end, but this is a way for you to show yourself mighty once again, that you'll show yourself strong once again, that you are the great I am, and you'll always provide for your children. Father, the word unemployed brings the idea of lack in the house, but there's no lack in the house of God. So Father, I ask in the name of Jesus that you hire, that you promote, that you give increase, that you have financial breakthrough, that you work these things out for their good. So they'll have a strong testimony that if it had not been for the Lord on their side, where would they be? So we pray all of this, Father, in the mighty and the majestic name of Jesus the Christ, our soon coming King. Hallelujah and amen. Amen. Come on, church. Come on, faith-based community. Let's end this prayer week in a high praise. Come on, let's give God praise right now. Let's lift up our voices. Let's say hallelujah. Let's say thank you, Jesus. You are worthy. You are worthy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for working it out for our good. Thank you for protecting us from dangers seen and dangers unseen. Thank you for looking beyond our faults and giving to our needs. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for that gift that helps us in all the way into eternity. You are the great I am. You are the great master. You are the great lifter up of my head. And we bless you right now. We end our week in high praise. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you, True Vision. God bless your faith-based community. God be with you this weekend. Join us. Join Pastor Brown Saturday night for Saturday Night Live as we get ready as our pep rally. That's our pep rally to get ready for worship. No matter what church you're part of, I thank you for inviting people to prayer. Now it's time to invite them to worship. We'll see you at 8, 9:30, or 11 on Sunday. God bless you. Have a great weekend. I can't say bye enough. I can't say bless you enough. God is with you. Holy Spirit, be kind to you. Jesus, be gracious unto you. Goodbye. We'll see you on Sunday. Amen. Oh.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you back to life. Back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most?